So you were always going to direct it.
Well, I didn't know whether I was always going to direct it. I mean, it really depends on where I was. And I wanted to come back and direct. I didn't, you know, I
you mean, we're talking about the one coming out.
For a long time, he was saying he didn't know that he was going to direct it. All of his friends were saying, oh, you got to direct it. You must do it yourself, blah, blah,
blah.
I got
a lot of attention.
Give him a lot of attention.
Not going to do it. Yeah. Oh, please.
Finally, you weren't getting any.
Oh, who was going to direct it?
I never really considered anybody else to direct it.
Ah, now it comes out.
Creating the exploding spaceships and lightsaber duels that would wow audiences was immensely difficult. In 1975, the special effects industry had all but died in Hollywood, and Lucas had to set up his own company, Industrial Light and Magic, not only to create the visual spectacle, but also to build the tools to do the job.
The skill and the capacity that was developed to generate the special effects was beyond anything that anyone had seen up to that time. And the effects used in a way that had never been attempted before. Real storytelling with effects.
It was just matter-of-fact stuff. When you think of Luke Skywalker first getting into that little hovercraft thing, you know, and just it was like getting into a car, driving to the next set of traffic lights, you know. There was that wonderful throwaway quality of this fantastic kind of other world.
Great, everyone wants to do that, don't they? Everyone wants to hurtle along floating off the ground like that. There's some really nasty skeletons coming up as well. You've seen the burnt skeletons of those parents.
Come on!
Quite graphic, isn't it?
Tour buses and fans now search out the obscure locations that inspired the look of Star Wars.
This is Ajim. It's a sponge fishing town. But 20 years ago, this was Mos Eisley. Luke Skywalker's land speeder cruises right through here, past these ruins, behind me to that building, which was the cantina where they hire Han Solo, their pilot. Now, in 1976, you've got a false entrance built out there. There's a dewback tethered off to the side. A few drunk Jawas sacked out in front of that doorway. But this was the place.
Everything in Star Wars is based on something here on Earth. It's a root of a design or an idea or a culture or an artifact that exists already. It has a very familiar and strong ethnic base.
George spelled out some very specific time periods that we should look at. One was going back to the 20s and 30s for sort of the Art Nouveau movement and the Art Deco movement. The other one was to go back to African art, which hasn't really been explored that well in film.
Check it out, Corporal. We'll cover you. Roger, roger.
Normally when you think of science fiction, you try to project ahead and you try to think, oh, you know, 2050 or whatever, and you try to come up with some really far out designs. And that's where the danger lies. Instead, George went back in history to design the future.
This is the Ksar of Mednin, a traditional Berber design of a type seen throughout southern Tunisia. Created as grain silos, each of these individual units, or ghorfas, is a storage chamber. The extraordinary aesthetic of the Berber Ksar offered an exotic and yet recognizably humble setting for the slave quarters, which are home to young Anakin Skywalker. It's in this street that Anakin bids goodbye to his mother as he leaves with the Jedi Knight Qui-Gon Jinn.
Welcome to the Episode 1 Art Department. This is where it all starts in terms of design. On this wall, you can see this is sort of George's first opportunity to see a lot of his written words implemented into a design. And what we try here is to try to, you know, come up with something that George likes. And you can see here, this is one of the early sketches for the attack tank.
Open fire.
One of the next stages is to actually implement them and combine them into a production painting. And in here, you can see this is the finished version of the attack tank. And the main purpose of the production paintings is to try to capture the mood and the drama of the of that moment. And hopefully, by picking out the key moments, it'll be enough to convey to the crew what the film is all about. One of the other problems that we do that we try to solve is once the designs are finished, is we normally try to build them as sort of hard surface maquettes or as sculpted maquettes. It's wonderful because once we get to this stage, George can look at it, see if it's working for him or not, and then if not...